So we're
okay,
on the
scribe.
All right, we started one dinner, full day's meal. We're on our second full day's meal. So when the first drop box was dinner.
Nobody knows what you're talking about.
And the second drop box, so we just disregard that. That wasn't. So we've gone 20. We have gone 28.3 until the first drop, which is four ammo cans, two each.
Which ain't as much as you think, because when we get to this drop, because our drop had to be kind of early.
Early
in the trip. So this is more of a place just to kind of top off and take a meal out and put a meal in, or kind of figure out our lunches and dinners for what we think might be three, possibly four more nights, depending on what we face.
Yeah. Okay. And then, you know, we had the
that's what he's trying to tell you there.
We had 47.7 miles worth of food with us.
He won the drafting award in our high school with meticulous lines and very, very nice print.
More lines right here.
here's another thing. Okay. This is Hickory stuff. Everything is hung neatly. Edges touching. Everything squared up. Socks in the same direction. Hickory, so?
Oh, I can taste the bacon.
That fake bacon.
It's good, man.
Yeah, we were just fixing to sit down and have ourselves a little dinner on Whale Rock. And the rain started coming down. Just a light tinkle. So we just sort of sit here and holler at each other. From tarp to tarp.
What?
Hello? My name's Sean.
My name's Ken.
And we're the Hickory Brothers. The reason we stopped a little bit early today,
early,
was as we were coming up the trail, where we were at Round Top Mountain, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Round Top Mountain. And it was only 4 o'clock, and we were feeling good and could have walked on a while. But we got a little ways to go, and we're going to come to our cache. And we'd rather do that tomorrow, because we got to get all of our food and fuel ready for the next three, possibly. We're going to plan for four. We are old, and we might not want to rush it, so we're not sure. But we were kind of in this area where you're... Had we gone on, there wasn't any water that we knew of, and we didn't see any good campsites, and we knew there was a good campsite right here with water. And so we decided to come down here, and we're going to get up very early,
early,
and try to be on the trail by 7 at the very latest, and just put in a more of a day that way. I hope that's a good explanation. All right, let me show you where we started. Right here. At Oconee State Park. We're going up this way. The first night, we called it Bible Belt Camp, Bible Brook Camp. We think it was about right there before Jumping Branch. That was our first little short night. We got on the trail about 3. Now we've gone on up. Yesterday we walked all of this. We camped up here, Burrell's Ford. Burrell's Ford Road, and we camped right there, my dirty finger pointed. And today we've come across here, right, past Fish Hatchery, and we walked up here to Sloan Bridge. And we went up this little, then that's where we ate at the picnic table. And then we came on up this way. Tonight we're camping right here, Round Mountain Gap, where that little tent is, up the dotted lines, which is a spur trail up to the parking. We're gonna crawl in, hit the sack. Good night, Kent. Good times.
Good times.
Yes, we are crashing on the early side of life tonight, so we can get up early. But I'm not sleepy at all. Yeah, it's 8 o'clock. Mom, can I stay up a little bit longer? Ready to go to sleep yet. We've got the rain tapping on the tarp just a little bit from the trees. And I am pretty tired. I mean, I feel good, great tonight. Whereas yesterday, it was a long day after my job and everything. I was ready to quit. I like talking this quiet. I put this into my life more often. Just talking a semi-whisper. Not really a real whisper. It's kind of a semi-whisper. But I was thinking today how fun this is to be out here with a friend you've had over 40 years, known each other since the sixth grade, Boy Scout troops, best man at my wedding. Just known him through thick and thin. I can't even begin to tell you the tales that we had in our youth. It would destroy the myth. The Maple King. Well, we may see him this trip. I don't know. I've seen glimpses. There's a harbinger of maple to come. I can't put my finger on it. Just like finishing this trail. Not really sure how long it's going to take. I'm just going to walk a day at a time. Mm-hmm. I didn't write that line, but it's a good line. I see your granddaddy long leg crawling behind you. You might want to feel it on your neck. Get it off, get it off, get it off.
He's a lonely boy. He's a lonely boy. He's a lonely boy.
What the?
Lonely boy.
He's a lonely boy. A little lonely boy. He's a lonely boy.
Out there is Lake Jocassee out in the distance. I'll have to lay music over this shot. Well, what have we been walking? 45 minutes? An hour, maybe? I hadn't checked, but kind of came down the mountain now, and we're at the one of the parking areas before Whitewater. And this is where we put our stash of food in the ammo boxes. So we're going to drop some stuff off, change some things out. And we'll be heavier when we leave. And we still got 47.9 miles to go. Woo, buddy! Okay, our cache is down this way. You come down the hill. And you look for a coffee cup that was out here. And there that is, the coffee cup.
Then you come over here where Hickory is.
Where Hickory is, we got a couple, found a couple old white wall tires. And that's where our secret booty is. Snake!
Snake! Somebody untied that knot. There it is.
And believe you me, them ammo cans don't hold as much as you think.
They might hold a lot of bullets. Oh, the seals are still on there.
I know I've got candy in mine! Candy.
Okay, you pick two, and I'll take the other two.
I'm gonna take the two middle ones, and we'll see what's in them. Down here right now through the rock scramble. Over to the bridge. And hey, I found a couple of toodly-doos. It's a duck call. That'll give you a little cable to pull yourself up on the rock, yeah. Oh boy. Thank you, Duke Power. You are my flower. Duke Power Power.
I think it's going to get steppy.
Is this where it is? There's supposed to be steps ahead.
Well, I heard they're engineers. They're not trail builders.
Hickory.
Nice to meet
you. You look familiar too. Have you
he's
been
the Maple
to
King. Well, all of our Limbo Gorge videos. He's my brother.
That? Oh, yeah. That's where I've seen.
That's the guy.
I've seen those Limbo Gorge.
Hey, this is Mike from Napoli, Florida.
Woo, buddy!
Did you get
Arrivederci.
Did you put this thing on record and hand it to me?
it's on record.
Oh.
Yeah.
Then we got that.
Maybe you can cut that little part out right
Does it say record right in there?
It does.
All right, we're recording.
All right.
Woo, buddy, Mike's walking it too. Out here on the FootHills Trail in North and South Carolina. We're
there
right
we
on
go.
The line.
Right here.
Right here.
North, I'm in South. I'm in North. I'm in South.
All right,
Dan's from South.
Look at that, would you? Just walking through a beautiful section here. It's like rambling through a park down by the Thompson River. We just passed the Whitewater Falls. Ran into a fella named Mike. You could just kind of stroll through this part. Woo! Well, Duke Power came down here and got to work. Must have brought the portable sawmill down. Oh, Hickory does love some lumber. That.
Yeah, this is a bandsaw. Bandsaw, just good sawdust. I'll find it.
Bandsaw material.
Bandsaw?
Bandsaw. They bandsawed it.
Okay, we've come 31.4 miles. And it sure feels like a lot further. And we still got to go.
Oh, there's horse pasture.
44.8 miles. That's old school. Stopping down here by the river to make a little water. I'm gonna go sit down on that rock where Hickory is. Stick my feet in the water and cool them off. Oh man, that feels marvelous. And we're still taking this break down here by the river, man. A guy we ran into named Mike down there, he came down and put his feet in the river. Man, we've all had our feet in the river an hour and a half. Well, about an hour. We've had our feet in the river for about an hour. I took my pants off and washed them. I washed my socks. Smell better already, though they're slightly damp because the sun went away. But man, beautiful, just a beautiful break down here, right down by that bridge right there, which I think, now I might be wrong because I even thought it was Wednesday today and I found out it was Tuesday. Thompson River Bridge.
Oh, the glory of these,
so cool.
It's freezing. My pad just won't do the job.
Now this is Mike. This is Big Money Mike, though. What do we call him?
Mike Dollar.
Dollar Mike.
Dollar Mike.
Dollar Mike.
Dollar Mike.
This is Dollar Mike here. We met him on the trail today. That's just a temporary name. And he's new to this hammock. First trip with it. Right?
Yes. First trip.
It's the Warbonnet XLC. And he's been using a pad. And what am I telling you? Look at the man. He's happy. He's out here with a pad, but he's never felt an underquilt.
Never.
So are you freezing right now?
I'm pretty chilly. My butt's kind of cold. Okay, so and this is chilly. Go. Chilly day.
And Mike likes Benny Hill music.
Okay.
All right. So now, I mean, that cord would be up over your feet.
Okay.
And then this one just tucks up on your
Oh,
shoulder.
My goodness. Oh.
Wow, that's amazing right there.
Isn't that amazing? You feeling it already?
I am very comfortable right now.
Shadow.
That is wonderful.
Oh, I got the shadow on
it. I could not believe
Look
that.
Look at that.
That is amazing.
You felt it though, didn't you?
I'm a happy camper,
okay.
As they say.
Now hang on a second. Keep the camera on his face, Kent.
Oh, he's going to grab your butt.
Your day, Mike.
Oh, no.
Do you feel that
mama.
Difference?
Oh, yeah.
That's a huge difference.
I can feel the difference. Right.
So then if you're laying in there yourself, now what I want you to do is just reach over and grab that corner right there, and that's kind of your set at night. You just want that tucked. And see what these do is they slide
up
and down this.
So you can adjust it wherever your shoulders are.
You want it about right there, because you usually have a pillow. And the other thing you want to make sure is that is not under your feet.
Uh-huh.
Then what's going to happen is you're going to get a gap right there. You'll feel some cold air. And you'll know.
So don't put this, make sure this is popped up like that.
For a three-quarter like this, yeah.
Got it. I see what you're saying.
Good.
Got it. Man, that is amazing. That's amazing.
You know, pad under your feet, and usually you don't ever feel, I never feel anything on my calf. Because
I don't either. I haven't had that problem.
That underquilt is about right there on you.
Okay, that's where it ends right there.
Right where my knees.
Right where my knees been.
And then right here on your back, that's.
Okay, man. And now you've got a lot more room in your hammock.
Oh,
you're
not
tied down with that, trying to stay on top of that pad all night long.
And you'll know at night, like, man, if you, sometimes, you know, you get up to pee and you get back in and your underquilt gets over, you know.
Then I
reach over and give it the tug.
You
get real good at the shoulder, just bringing it up to your shoulder.
Just like that.
That's your place. And you, once you become it, you'll just, your ham will go there. It's like touching your wife. Oh, she's in.
Exactly. $20 for me to use it tonight.
Oh, we have to do better than that. Okay. How much you got on you?
Okay, man. Not enough. That is
great.
You
got any candy?
You want me to read it for you and tell you?
Candy?
I got my glasses on right now.
It.
I'll tell you right now.
It's really quite pathetic.
Hello, do I look smarter with these?
Absolutely.
Men of a certain age, man, we're just lost without our peepers. I'm going to read his thing there. Boy, that thing's about wore down.
I know.
Looks like top of stove, 1.5 cups of water.
Okay, that's about one. I think I'm in good shape there.
Yeah, you'd be good.
Thank you, Captain.
They usually make those things kind of runny.
Yeah.
And I'm going to have, back at Gourmet, Tuscan beef stew with Parmesan polenta. Roasted beef and veggies in a burgundy wine sauce over creamy polenta.
Who needs to go back home to get a steak or a barbecue? We can just have that.